single hair graft or double or triple hair graft? What would be the best choice for eyebrows and why? Hi, I have a decision about an eyebrow transplant. I will do an eyebrow transplant with the same shape and size to increase density. The doctor analyzed that I should do about 200 grafts on each side. I have a choice whether I do a single hair graft or double hair graft or triple hair graft. What would be the best choice for eyebrows and why? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. So you're planning to have eyebrow transplant, and it's been recommended that you have 200 grafts per eyebrow, and you're asking about single hairs, two hairs, and three hair grafts. Well, in terms of eyebrow transplants, traditionally, most of the hairs, if you look at a natural eyebrow and how that grows, tends to be one and two hairs, okay, groupings. And of course, they're placed, or actually they naturally grow in a way that's almost parallel to the skin. So if you're asking about the kinds of grafts that you need, well, you have to also, it's kind of hard to guess that without having a closer view of the type of hairs you have existing and the size of the slits that need to be placed. You see, the art of transplantation is more than just choosing large grafts to cover more space. It has to look natural. And so it's almost like asking an artist, you know, what size brush do you like to use? It depends. It depends on what you're trying to do. But I want to let you know a couple of things that could factor into your decision in terms of the perspective of how we do eyebrow transplants in our practice. In my practice, I have had the good fortune of using this material called extracellular matrix made by a company called ACell. Now, this material I have been able to use to help improve the survivability of the hair grafts that I place for any type of hair transplant. You see, one of the things that people in the hair transplant field don't always talk about is that there is a certain percentage of hair grafts that don't often take. So when people in this field start to offer patients will to more grafts and more grafts than everybody else, well, that may not be a good idea, because sometimes putting more grafts results in more loss. So you're putting in a lot of hairs, but survivability is an issue. So to address this, we have been using this material called extracellular matrix, which stimulates the body to heal by duplication or by recruiting adult stem cells that enhances healing. This is a world of medicine, and I think the next step in our profession has to do a lot with stem cells and regenerative technology. This, in the University of Pittsburgh, the McGowan Institute has been amazing about the things they've been doing using this material to help people who have come back from the military who have lost muscle, and these people with this material are able to regrow muscle and be able to walk and run. So it's remarkable. So when I do this procedure, I normally use this material in a couple of ways. One is to help the area of that I'm placing the grafts heal. Two is to help the donor area heal so that when it heals with almost no perceptible scar and the hairs grow through it. But in addition, I've been using the material as a non-surgical solution for thinning hair. Now, in some of our hair, in our eyebrow transplant patients, their problem is about thinning eyebrow hairs. And so we have found that the thinning eyebrow hairs can respond with the injection alone and respond even really well when we do a transplant. Something to also be aware of is when incisions are made in the eyebrow, invariably a certain percentage of the native hairs can be injured from the act of making the openings. That happens for any transplant, whether it's on the scalp or otherwise. If you're not in just bald skin, there are going to be hair follicles that get injured. Well, using this material, we find that we are not dealing with that injury issue as much. And how we know that is there's something called shock loss that happens where not only do the hair follicles that you've implanted temporarily go into a resting phase, but some of the native hairs go into a shock phase and they fall out. So you can imagine how distressing that is for someone to go for a transplant, lose a lot of hair first, and then start regrowing several months later. In my experience, combining this material with really good surgical technique has been working out very, very well. There's still a growth cycle. There's still, you could still experience a lot of this. But this is where the art is. So I think that if your doctor is highly experienced in eyebrow transplantation, then follow your doctor's lead. And remember that it does take time for the hairs to grow in and to look the way you want it to look. And in addition, you will have to continuously trim those hairs because they are going to continue growing longer than your native eyebrow hairs. So essentially, as far as choosing the kinds of grafts that you need, I think you and your doctor need to have a conversation, and you should have an understanding of the logic behind how those choices are being made. So I know I've introduced a new concept to you about regenerative medicine and hair loss, but I hope that will help you make your decision moving forward. So I thank you for your question, and I wish you the best of luck.